Hello everyone, my name is Vikal Jain and today I am going to nullify debit and credit entries in Excel. So even you can say it as we are going to nullify positive and negative entries. So here we have 1000 entries. As you can see on the screen, it is 1000. Now we are going to nullify all the entries and we are going to find out the remaining entries which are not nullifying. So what we are going to do, we are going to do some steps so that we can extract that data. So let's begin. So for nullifying the entry, we are going to use ABS first. So what ABS do? ABS convert all the number into positive. It will also convert the negative number into positive and positive number into positive. So let's try ABS. So drop and down. Now I'm going to sort this data according to ABS. Now you can see here is one positive, one negative, one negative, one negative. So 2 is nullifying. So let's try to find out the list. We are going to make a pivot table here. Insert pivot table. So I'm inserting on the existing worksheet here. Now okay. Now I'm using ABS in the rows column and numbers in the values. So let's try to understand this pivot table. For this we need to divide E column from D column. E5 divided by D5, drag and drop. Now it is saying 2 has no balance entry, 5 is having one minus entry. You can see 5, one minus entry is not offsetting. 7, again one positive entry is not offsetting, one positive entry is not offsetting. 10 minus 2, it means both are negative entries and both are not offsetting. So let's try to build a list from this data. What we are going to do, we are going to copy this data to another sheet, copy and insert a new sheet, paste special and values. Now let's give a name. Here it is the data which we are checking, and this is the count. Now I don't need this anymore, so let's increase the size of sheet. Now again we are going to find out the ABS of this count. ABS. Now what we are going to do, we are going to delete the offsetting entry which have already offset, that we are going to delete since we are not going to find out those entries. So let's put a filter, Control Shift L. Now remove 0 entries. So these all entries are offsetting completely. I'm deleting this. Now I'm going to repeat these entries. For example, I'm going to repeat 5 one time, 6 one time, 10 twice. So I'm going to repeat and build a list once again here. So let's try to find out a cumulative. So cumulative would be 1. And now to find out the cumulative, I am not going to add this plus 1, I am going to add this plus this. Here it is. Now drag and drop. Since we are going to put a VLOOKUP, so I am going to cut this column and paste it here. Now our VLOOKUP table is ready. Now let's put a serial number from 1 to 657. How I have identified the 657? You can see the last cumulative is 657, so I am identifying that. Now this plus 1, so I am identifying, I am just typing the serial number to 1 to 657. So for this I am going to use Control G since I am on the cell 2, so I need to type 6, sorry, I need to type G658. Okay, now control D, my list is ready, serial number is ready. Now I'm going to use the VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP, lookup value is this and data is this. Locket, comma 2. I'm going to use approximate match. Now you can see 10 is repeating twice, so I have put the 10 twice. Now you can see all 657 numbers are appearing, which are not offsetting. Now the problem is sign. We need to put a sign over here. So what we are going to do, we are going to use if function here. If this is negative, it means less than 0, then I want minus 1, else 1. Now I am going to use VLOOKUP once again. Insert a column to separate this data. VLOOKUP, lookup value is this. Locket, table array is this. F4, comma 2, comma 0. Drag and drop. Now multiplying these two, this multiply by this. Now your list is ready. So this list is not offsetting. You can see 2 minus 10 entries are not offsetting. You can see 2 and minus 10, 2 entries are not offsetting. Again, minus 5, 1 entries is not offsetting. Minus 5, 1 entry is not offsetting. So here is the results. So keep enjoying and keep learning.